guys. God bless you. How are you doing today? Today we have a new lecture, a new video about the gospel. Today we have lecture number 23 that is called Life of the Believers. And today we're going to see an example in the apostles, an example in the early church, the church that arose when Jesus resurrected and when he left his Holy Spirit to be with us for the eternity. So now, before starting, let us pray. Okay, so if you can close your eyes. Heavenly Father, we thank you in this moment because you are giving your answer to us. Please help us to remain faithful to you, Lord. We want to be here to serve you, and we want to fulfill with the purpose that you have given to our lives. And we know that that purpose is to believe in your Son, Lord, that all of the scriptures were written so that we may believe that you are the Christ, the Son of the living God, and that by believing we may have life in your name. And thank you, Lord, because that is your gift, that is your grace, that you has given eternal life for us. Thank you because you have good plans for us and you love us, Lord. We put this time in your hands and we ask you to be you guiding us and talking to our lives. In the precious name of Jesus, whom is the Christ, we have prayed today. Amen. So guys, this is lecture number 23, Life of Believers.
To start this lecture, let us remember the covenant that God gave to the first man, that man not to eat from the fruit of the tree of knowledge of good and evil. And the covenant was the only thing man had to keep to be with God. But we know what happened. The serpent deceived Adam and he disobeyed God, breaking that covenant. And we know that Adam disobeyed God because he didn't believe when God said that he would die when he ate from the fruit. Instead, he preferred to believe in what Satan said. So, what we can see here is that Adam's true sin was not to believe in the word of God. And we know that when we disobey to our parents, there's a consequence, right? So, it was the same to Adam. As he disobeyed his father, all the problems started in Adam's life and in all mankind's life. But we see that it is the same problem that unbelievers nowadays have. They are disobedient because they are still governed by Satan, who is the spirit that works now in the people who is disobedient, just as we can read in Ephesians chapter 2, verse 2. You used to live in sin, just like the rest of the world, obeying the devil, the commander of the powers in the unseen world. He is the spirit at work in the hearts of those who refuse to obey God. But guess what? There was someone who was absolutely obedient, and he did it for our benefit, so that we may get salvation, and it was Jesus, when he fulfilled his work as the Christ. And we can read this in Hebrews chapter 5, verse 8 and 9. Even though Jesus was God's son, he learned obedience from the things he suffered. In this way, God qualified him as a perfect high priest, and he became the source of eternal salvation for all those who obey him. We know that even Jesus gave up his privileges as God for love and mercy to us. He humbled himself, accepting the most painful and shameful death, so that through his obedience we may be righteous before God's eyes. And as he was perfectly obedient, God placed all things under his feet. It means that he has the power over everything. He is the main authority. And even in things of this world, we need to obey those who are the head, right? For example, our parents or those who are in charge in the government. So, can you imagine how much more we have to obey our Eternal Father, who has the power of all the universe? So now we know that Jesus taught us and gave us the best example through his life. So, as he showed obedience, obedience is now that we who have believed that Jesus is the Christ must have. And let us read some verses about this that we are talking about. The first one, we can find it in the book of Hebrews chapter 12 verse 9. Since we respected our earthly fathers who disciplined us, shouldn't we submit even more to the discipline of the Father of our spirits and live forever? Then guys, we have already learned about the way that leads us to salvation, and we know that it is through belief in Jesus as the Christ. But now in this lecture, we are learning that if we believe it, we also need to obey it. And obedience will come naturally as a consequence when we believe. And all of this gives glory to God, just as we can read in 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 13. As a result of your ministry, they will give glory to God. For your generosity to them and to all believers will prove that you are obedient to the good news of Christ. Then guys, here it is confirmed once again that our life has to be a life of obedience, a life that shows that we have believed in Jesus as the Messiah. Amen.
Okay guys, so now you learned and now we learned that obedience is the life of the believers, and now we know what do we have to obey, right? Now we know why do we need to be obedient and what do we need to obey. So to close this time, let us pray to thank the Lord for all these that he has allowed to us to learn and to share about this answer for our lives. So please close your eyes. Thank you, Lord, because you are giving us today this is your gospel, Lord. And thank you because you has given your only begotten Son for us to believe in him, Lord. And thank you because by believing in him, we are made your children. And now we belong to you. You are our God and we are your people, Lord. We want to serve you in spirit and we want to worship you in truth. In spirit and in truth, Lord, because you are looking for those worshipers. And Lord, we ask you today to be brave and to share this gospel with our friends, with our families. And we want to have that life that the early church had, that they didn't care about their own lives, about their problems. They gave everything they were for you, for your sake, only to share your gospel, Lord. Please take us to that point in our lives that we do not care about ourselves anymore, and to only care about you, Lord, and your work. We want to be like those apostles that you utilized in the first century, Lord. We exalt your name and we glorify your name in this time. In the precious name of Jesus, whom is the Christ, we have prayed. Amen. So guys, that was lecture number 23, Life of Believers, and see you next time.